All right, hello everybody, welcome back. Let's get started with one of those bad boys right there. So I have something new, exciting, and special for you, like I always have. This one here is a relatively new product by IK Multimedia, and it's called the Axe.io. The Axe.io is an interface for guitarists. Let me change the camera view. I'll give you a close-up shot of what it looks like, and then we'll go through features and functions. So let's check it out. Okay, so what we have over here is the Axe.io, and it is a very compact audio interface, again, for guitarists. On the front panel, you could see you have a quarter-inch jack input, a gain control. We're going to go through these features over here, the Z-tone or the impedance. We have another gain for another instrument, a preset knob, a tuner, monitor for direct monitor or affected, okay? We have headphone jacks, master. We have reamp feature in this, so if you want to route your dry, unaffected signal into a real amp and back into that, into this unit, you can do that, okay? And then on the back of it, you have full MIDI in and out, two external pedals, so external switching if you want to do like A, B, and a wah, something like that, four line outputs. It's really five outputs when you think about the reamp jack on the front panel, and then two combo jacks on the back for quarter inch or XLR. So if you want to play your guitar and sing, that type of thing, you can do it. Okay. With that said, as I mentioned, I have the unit here and I am using this to control amplitude, and I'll walk through some settings of different amp sounds that you could get with this. What I'd like to do is really just jump into some of the very specific and unique features that make this for guitarists, okay? So we have Z-tone, which is your impedance matcher. You have for active and passive pickups, and you know, different, the impedance, the way the pickup interacts with your amplifier really depends on if it's an active or a passive pickup, okay? They have accounted for that right here on the front panel. So I'm using passive pickups in my Gordon Smith, and I have it on passive. But if I was using active, I switch it to active. And really, again, it just helps get the most out of your instrument. Over here, you have your pure and your bold JFET. The bold JFET will give you more dynamic, more rich harmonics. And then this will really just allow you to fine-tune the impedance. So it's all the in-between stuff. I know that's kind of a description, but we're going to use our ears and hear what all of this means. I have my JCM 800 style amp up on Amplitube, and let me kill the vocal mic, and let's just look at some of the tone controls on the front. Here we go. What's interesting, when I dropped it down to active, you could hear there was a little decrease in volume, which is compensating because I have passive pickups in here. Active pickups are typically hotter, so you want the little decrease so it's not so harsh. That was clear as a bell to me. The Z-tone was clear as a bell also. All the way up, you could hear it smooth things out. All the way down, it was very crisp. So I kind of picked my setting based on the amp model that I'm using right there. And I'll also give you a clean tone, so don't go anywhere. But these are the very unique controls that will really help you fine-tune your guitar tone into this interface, which again is very unique for this particular interface catering to guitarists. You also have some other cool features here. We have a tuner. Okay, so you have the tuner over there. You also have this preset knob, and the preset knob is really cool because you could do a few things with it. You can control certain features in the software itself, okay? So I'm going to go to the software and show you what we have going on over here. So when you're over here and you click on MIDI, you could come over here to control change, and you have your global parameters here. So you could have that control whatever you want. Out of the box, it controls your presets. But you could change that, okay? So that is that. And also, something else I would like to point out here is this blue board. So what's cool about this is, you know, when you think about all of these modeling units that are very popular out there, right? We know who they are. A lot of that purchase price is actually CPU, right? The actual computer aspect of those modeling. In theory, you can use your laptop with this and accomplish the same goal. You have a foot switch, which works with MIDI. You could assign different amps and different rigs to this. So on stage, you can actually change your amp types with something like this, which is also made by IK Multimedia, and switch all of your different presets, which is pretty cool because, again, if you want to, you don't want to spend thousands of dollars on, you know, a sophisticated piece of gear that will give you modeling. You could get something like this, your guitar, your interface, your laptop. This fits in a laptop bag. You have your floorboard, and you can set up all your presets and all your rigs the way you want, toggle between. And then you have full, as the name suggests, I/O. So you could do output to a mixing board. You could do output to front of house, that type of thing. You could even go into a power amp if you wanted to do something like that. You have the capability to do that with the I/O that this is capable of doing. Okay, so what I'd like to do now is go through some amp settings over here. So here's a nice Fender tone. Let's check this bad boy out. So you could see it's just, it works well. You could shape your tone in the front. Let me show you something else here. I'm going off on a little bit of a tangent here, but this is very powerful software. You could use Amplitube in your DAW software, so whatever you might use, Pro Tools, I use Sonar here, Logic, whatever it might be. Or you could use it as a standalone, and the program itself also has an 8-track recorder, which is kind of cool, and a looper, and you could see that right over there. It's grayed out. And then you could do your inserts, and you could see over here I have my reverb, which is, you know, just adds that little bit of lushness to it. So it's really good software. You could do your stomp boxes, and even if you wanted to control the stomp box with the blue board, you could do that as well. So pretty cool stuff. Let me show you something else here. You can actually play through this without any latency, is because you could see over here the buffer size is very low. I actually have that buffer size set at 32, which means when I play, the amount of millisecond is really, it's down to nothing almost. So the USB connection, and by the way, this laptop is a Thunderbolt port, so I'm doing USB into a little Thunderbolt dongle, and there is no latency at all. But if you were recording after you lay down all your tracks, you could put the latency up. You really want the latency low for when you're playing. This way you don't hear your string pick and then you hear the sound. So that's all, again, that's all built in here. And also, while we're on the screen, the MIDI input right now is AXIO. But if I click down over here, you could see my iRig blue board is there. So if I'm on stage and I want to control the amps with the foot switch, I could do that. If I want to use the this knob over here, the preset to control, you know, studio recording and use that to control something specific in the software, I would set it to AXIO. In fact, let me show you how you would use this this on a stage. So let's do that real quick, okay? So I'm gonna set this over here to iRig Blue Board. I'm gonna click OK. And then what I'm gonna do over here is I'm gonna come over here to MIDI, and here are my program changes. So check this out. And I'll put this over here so you could actually see what's going on. So now if I do this, let's say over here I wanna do, let's go to British Collection, and I want it to be a Silver Jubilee on a lead channel. And then I want my second one to be, let's come over here to collections. We're going to go down to orange. I'm going to use my OR120, which I really like. And we'll do like a clean OR120. I'll come over here to a third one. And let's just, let's see. I don't know. Let's see what else we have here. Collections. Fender 2. And I think I'm on a 57 or 65 Super Reverb. I think that's what I'm on. 65 Super Reverb, and we'll do a Blues Rhythm. And then we'll do the fourth thing over here. Let's just pick a JCM 800 Crunch. Okay, I'm gonna click OK here. Now watch this. So on here, there's one amp, there's two amps, there's three amps, there's four amps. So let me show you now over here. This is, let's go to A. Here's my Silver Jubilee. B is my orange. C is my Fender. And D is my JCM 800. So again, you can use this to actually use this live. So with low latency, you can play and hear, kind of like you're plugged right into an amp. You can use this to control the rigs that you're using, and you can shape it really depending on whatever guitar you have. You can shape the front controls to really just give you the best tone there is. So that is the quick video on the AXIO by IK Multimedia. I do want to thank them for giving me an opportunity to check it out. It's no secret, I've been a fan of their stuff for a long time. I've covered a lot of their products in the past. And this one is really cool because, again, it caters to guitarists. It's not just a generic run-of-the-mill audio interface. A lot of controls here for guitarists. You know, this box here is very critical. You have the tuner over here. The size of it is very convenient. Throw this and your laptop and one of these bad boys in your bag. You have your whole rig on a budget because this doesn't break the bank. That's it. You know, great I.O. Again, you have four outputs in the back. I'm doing stereo right now, but I have two extra outputs. So if I wanted to run front of house or do something else, run into a real amp or something like that, or one of these FR devices, I could. You know, it's got the whole thing going on. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you dig it, give me some thumbs up. If you want to see more like it, hit that subscribe button. Thank you for watching. I'll leave you all off with one of those bad boys right there, and we'll see you later.